baby, won't you meet me by the beam? Too early, maybe later, you could show me things. You know what it is whenever I visit Windy City, she blowing me kisses. No, too dirty, baby, won't you meet me by the beam? Too early, baby, later, you could show me things. You know what it is whenever I visit Windy City, she blowing me kisses. No.
Episode 5. I am your host, Belinda, also known as underscore Zen Rabbit. The idea is that we are taking you on a night drive with us to reset your creative mind. We'll be sharing dope music, videos, and art along the way. Sit back and enjoy traveling through our universe. It's the journey, not the destination. Yee. Yeah, this track behind us right now is called Monty Discord by J Rob.
Every night, I've been baby, I'll go before my night. Yeah, need a job. Erg is the name. Pinballer did the chain. Tono for the watch. Prezi plain Jane. Rookie and Bikini chain. Rest in peace to my superior. Hermes linga feed the village in Liberia. TMZ taking pictures causing my hysteria. Mama see me all BT and start tearing up. I'ma start killing niggas. How'd you get that truck? I attended Harlem picnics when you risk your life. Uncle used to skim work selling nicks at night. I was only 8 years old watching Nick at night. Uncle Psycho was in that bathroom.
Track playing right now is called Plain Jane, spelled P-W-A-I-N-J-A-N-E. It's by Wayne Valentine. It's pretty fire at it. Yeah, good job, man. C-O-U-T-H, cause you can't spell it either. If I call him Penny, coming home, swallowing double G. This must be eating because I spread it by them feeders. Told you know that you my son, I should have scrapped you as a feeder. All these bitches rocking inches cause they following the leader. I should switch it up on hoes and rock that afro like Medina. I don't keep up with the Joneses, but I do know Captain Zeta. I'm with Candace, T.T. Timby, and Viola, me amiga. Reptors, they gotta check in with the queen. I'm the alpha, the omega, everything in between. Oh, ride with Manon, mashallah. Check in with me, pin to your job. Queen is the name, Raffaello to the chain. This is Monse. Good, man. But we're going to get into some movie clips now. Well, just one movie clip for now. It's in the movie. I can't talk right now. I'm sorry, guys. Give me a second. Hold up. I'm collecting myself. Hey, what's up? Yes. Okay, so I'm about to drop a movie clip right now from The Brothers Bloom. And this character, she's talking about how she basically had to spend her entire childhood locked up inside of her house, quarantined from 5 until 19. They thought that she was allergic to everything, but she really wasn't. And it's like this locked in feeling that it's been all year for me. And I don't know, this clip still resonates. And trying to find the beauty in even the simplest things. You know, like that's been a challenge for me, but I'm learning, you know, one day at a time, right? So, yeah. All right, I'm gonna play this clip now. You're gonna get into it.
When they begin, the beginning. Bring back. like the sound of music so tender.
You look very nice.
It brings back a night of tropical splendor. It brings back a memory evergreen.
What was your childhood like?
I make hammers out of watermelons.
Lonely?
When I was 5, I got really bad rashes and allergies and hay fever. So my mom took me to the doctor, and he did that test where they use needles to prick a grid on your back with different toxins on them, you know, to see which ones you're allergic to. Next day I come in, doctor lifts up my shirt, and my back is a patch of oily, moldy, blackish green double puff marshmallows. I was allergic to everything. So they sealed the house with plastic and a special ventilation system, and I spent the rest of my childhood and adolescence indoors, alone. Lonely.
No.
It wasn't until I was 19 they discovered what I was actually allergic to was the aluminum alloy the hypodermic needles were made out of. Then I was gonna leave, but my mom got sick. So I stayed. She stayed sick a really long time.
Do you, feel cheated?
Trick to not feeling cheated is to learn how to cheat. So I decided this wasn't a story about a miserable girl trapped in a house that smelled like medical supplies, wasting her life on a dying person she sometimes hated. No. This was a story about a girl who could find infinite beauty in anything, any little thing, and even love the person she was trapped with. And I told myself this story till it became true. Now, did doing this help me escape a wasted life? Or did it blind me so I wouldn't want to escape it? I don't know. But either way, I was the one telling my own story, so no, I don't feel cheated at all.
Man, so good, dude. So good. Yeah, finding the infinite beauty in anything, that's and the stories we tell ourselves, right? It's all about our perspective, you know? Whether or not we're gonna let the bitterness get to us or if we're gonna be able to find the sweetness, right? In the vinegar. So, yeah. Thanks for watching that with me, you guys. Appreciate it. I'm gonna rewind this next track called It Will Be Better This Way by Will FXX or Will Felix. It's spelled WLLFLXX. The next three tracks are by this producer, actually, and he's really fire. This track is called Early Christmas Love by CD, spelled S-E-E-D-E-E, and again, W-L-L-F-L-X-X, Wilflex. I don't know how to say his name right. Yeah, the last three tracks though have been by that producer. Check him out, man, it's fire. I'm about to play some movie clips from this movie, Take the Lead. I think it was released in 2006. Man, throwback, but Swizz Beatz produced, or like basically orchestra, like did all the music supervision and did all these crazy edits, and the dance sequences are fire. So yeah, enjoy.
Got rhythm, I got music, I got my man. Who could ask for anything more? I got daisies in green pastures. I got my man. Who could ask for anything more?
Who could dance with us, or who could stand with us? Look at us tonight, we looking fabulous. Freshed it up to death and we just moving.
Out on the town, putting on our dance shoes in. 1 foot in and 1 foot out. The sexy salsa, what's that all about? Well, listen, as I take it back to old school and like Lena Horne, all them cats was cooling. The lead, but yo, I can't take it when that young thing like to shake, shake it, shake it. When she move forward and she back the thing up, and I gotta be on point and live on something. Cause my hood is greasy, it ain't easy, but for tonight, gonna be alright.
Dude, so crazy. Who would have thought to combine ballroom dancing and hip hop, man? So, and yeah, if you peep the credits, it said music by Aaron Zygmunt and Swizz Beatz. So, man, the guy was on one. Hold up. I'm going to play the next clip now. Give me 1 second.
Out.
Yeah, man, Antonio Banderas is a G. Sheesh. So fire, dude. Yeah. Next clip is fire as well. Hey, let me hear you say,
I like that. Now, what happened to George and Ira?
And hey, retire, man.
Demo time. Let me hear you say, I like that. Now,
what you think about it? You look a little confused.
It's simple, really. We scratch two different joints together, but the underbelly of the beats are all the same. So watch. It's the bottom beat that I'm dancing to now, but I can change it up, though. Yo, E, flip it.
You better stop. I like it when the music come on so we can just rock like this. I like it when the beat just pumps so we can just smoke like this.
I mean, it's simple. You can take out the underbelly and dance to the top of the beat. Or you can take out the top and dance to the underbelly. It's crazy, right? It's tight.
No.
Yes.
Two songs. Working together.
Yeah.
This is a beautiful idea.
Yeah.
Which means we could use, let's say, your music with my music, and then back to your music. Let me try something. This one. All right, see if this works.
All right.
Number four.
This better be something new.
The way you wear your hat.
Now, these are the basic beats for salsa, right? Good. Now I want you to fall in and count with me. Underbelly rhythm only.
Here.
All right. Good. Now partner up.
Yeah.
Oh. Let's see.
Your voice crazy, man.
Eyes off of the floor. Your soul is not in your feet. All right.
Hey, let me hear you say. The way you wear your hat. Wanna what's still winning? Homie, you'll always be a runner up.
Monster, you're too big. Every move you make is like the Rocky Mountains.
I'm sorry.
Mr. Pierre, I need another partner.
Right? On.
Wanna dance with me?
Better not. Didn't you see what just happened? They call me Monster for a reason. I'm just not made to dance.
Monster, do you like dancing?
Yeah, I guess so.
Then you're made to dance.
I like it when the music come on so we can just rock like this. I like it when the beat just pumps so we can just move like this.
Whoa.
No.
What is the name of that move you just did?
Ain't got no name. What you looking at is history in the making.
Yeah, let's do it.
Rose gold sit on my neck. Rose gold sit on my wrist. Got on you and your you better stop.
Guys, why don't you try just to dance together? Let's try.
Follow me into a solo, get in the flow, and you can picture like a photo. Music makes mellow, maintains to make melodies for MCs, motivates the bricks. I'm everlasting, I can go on for days and days with rhymes displays that engrave deep as x-rays. I can take a phrase that's rarely heard, flip it, now it's a daily word.
All right, walk forward, everyone.
And let me say, yeah,
you know what I'm,
come on,
let's go.
What you think about it?
I like it, I like it.
And let me say,
yeah.
What you think about it?
I like it. Woo! I like it.
Come on.
Man, so good. So good, dude. Yeah. Really loved that movie. Super underrated in my opinion. They killed it with the music and dancing and Antonio Banderas. All right, gonna get back into some music. This track about to get into right now is called Why. It's a flip by D Don't Care.
Why is the industry designed to keep the artists in debt? And why them dudes ain't riding if they party is set? And why they never get it popping but they party to death? Yeah, and why they gon' give you life or murder? Turn around, only give you 8 months for a burner. It's going down, why they selling niggas CDs for under a dime? And if it's all love, daddy, why you come with your nine? Why my niggas ain't get that cake? Why it's a brother up north better than Jordan that ain't get that break? Why you ain't stacked instead of trying to be fly? Why it's ratting at an all-time high? Why are you even alive? Why they kill Tupac and Crew? interest. Why at the bar you don't take straight shots instead of popping crisps? Why them bullets have to hit that door? Why did Kobe have to hit that raw? Why he kissed that whore? Why? Around them cowards. Why Aaliyah have to take that flight? Why my nigga D ain't pull out his Ferrari? Why he take that bike? Why they gotta open your package and read your mail? Why they stop letting niggas get degrees in jail? Why you gotta do 85% of your time? And why do niggas lie in 85% of their rhymes? Why a nigga always want what he can't have? Why I can't come through when the pecan jag? Why they crack have to hit so hard even though it's almost over? Why niggas can't get no jobs? Why they come up with the witness protection? Why they let the Terminator win the election? Come on, pay attention. Why sell in the stores what you can sell in the streets? Why say the hottest shit but we selling the least? Why? Denzel have to be crooked before he took it? Why they didn't make the CL6 with a clutch? And if you don't smoke, then why the hell you reaching for my Dutch? Why rap? Cause I need airtime. Why be on the curb with a wild lie? I need a fair sign. Why all the young niggas is dying? Cause they moms at work, they pops is gone, they living with iron. Why they ain't give us a cure for AIDS? Why my diesel have fiends in the spot on the floor for days? Why you screaming like it's a slug? It's only the Hulk. Why my buzz in LA ain't like it is in New York? Why they forcing you to be hard? Why ain't you a thug by choice? Why the whole world love my voice? Why I trying to tell them that it's the flow, son? And you know why they made the new 20s, cause I got all my old ones. That's why.
All that I've been giving is this pain that I've been living. Thank you.
This track is called Getting You by, again, WLLFLXX, Will Flex. That's, and now we're about to get into some Rain on My Bacata by Montezuma. It's on Sophisticated Delinquency on SoundCloud. Check it out. Started playing this a little too soon, guys. Sorry. I got one more take the lead track, or take the lead clip, and then we'll get into this track right here. Got a little too carried away. My bad, my bad. We got this, though. We're gonna get this down. Yee!
La Comparsita.
Thank you.
best of the best. And when the kick drum kick and it's in your chest, and then it gets real deep within it, we gonna get them. We shake and vibrate and take the rhythm.
Man, so fire, dude, so fire. All right, we're gonna get back into the track now. Now that I got it down. Yee. All right, yes, back to this boom bap dot baby Keem track by DJ Quay Rico.
Rico.
Bitch, sit on my face, I had that. Choose up, Lil John, I'm finna pack him. When it comes to my bitch, I'm straight active. Dirt ball in the coupe, smoking cactus. Lil bitch, shut the fuck up. Tell your best friend, shut the fuck up, ayy. Lil bitch, shut the fuck up. Tell your best friend, shut the fuck up, ayy. You know I love it when you talk dirty. Messy, you my orange soda shorty. You act like a Lil me, I wanna fuck you. You the type to kill me, I won't touch you. You want me drop a band on some cute shoes. You want me be the man you can vent to. You let me beat it up, you let me practice. Now I'm finna lay you on the mattress. Bitch, sit on my face, I attack that. Juice up, Lil John, I'm finna pack him. When it comes to my bitch, I'm straight active. Dirt ball in the coupe, smoking cactus. Lil bitch, shut the fuck up. Tell your best friend, shut the fuck up, hey. Lil bitch, shut the fuck up. Tell your best friend, ayy, shut the fuck up, ayy. My lil' baby, low-key a factor. 6 figs on the whip, that's a price tag. Lil' best friend, bitch, try to press me. I'm that underground nigga with the check, though. I hit a bitch that I can't impress. When you come, see the crib, you better die, ho. Young nigga sneaking in through your side, yo. Baby King, not a wave, I'm a fly, ho. 7 fig nigga with the big drip on me. Post on your block with your wishlist on me. Bitch, sit on my face, I attack that. Choose up, Lil John, I'm finna pack him. When it comes to my bitch, I'm straight active. Dirt ball in the coupe, smoking cactus. Lil bitch, shut the fuck up. Tell your best friend, shut the fuck up, ayy. Lil bitch, shut the fuck up. Tell your best friend, shut the fuck up, ayy.
Across the floor, I mean you run through my mind.
So this track is called Take You's Home by Wayne Valentine, again for the win. Had a couple of Wayne Valentine tracks on this playlist. It's good vibes, dude. Yeah, thanks.
Represent that. Represent that. Represent that.
Trojan horse out in the open, baby. out in the opening. He come to me, I'm thugging out in the opening. Wanted out in the opening. I see the beast, they gunning out in the open. Say fuck them out in the opening. I puff the weed in public out in the open. They hunt us out in the open.
Again, this track is called Ayman Omari Sound Pack Contest by CD. And yeah, I got one more clip for you guys and then we'll close the hour out. Thanks for joining.
Beyonce, her dad came in and he heard the song Girl playing loud. He said, oh, this is a smash. This is a hit. He looked at me and was like, you made this beat, son? I said, yes, sir. And Beyonce turned to him and said, Daddy, he made it on that.
In hip hop, sampling is like alchemy. It's an art form that rearranges space and time. And the producers who build on the tradition use sonic DNA from the past to cook up the future. Now, even when you know how it works, it can still feel like magic. The name Ninth Wonder says it all. A proven innovator with a disciplined approach, he lends every sample he touches his own sense of soul. And that becomes clear in surprising ways when he breaks down the three beats he composed that all went into a single song from Kendrick Lamar's Pulitzer-winning album, Damn.
The first song I sampled in Kendrick Lamar's Duckworth is a song by Ted Taylor, and the song was called Be Ever Wonderful. Once again,
just to remind you, sweetheart, that my love for you has...
A lot of times, producers listen to samples and they say, that's a great sample, but he didn't do it right. It's just like fashion. And maybe a shirt on this side, the jacket's over here, but it takes a mind to put all those together. It's the same thing with records. It's like, if you don't know how to dress this up, man, just don't wear it. Sometimes people make beats and don't understand body motion means a lot, especially when it comes to the region you're making the beat for. So if I'm thinking of classic West Coast, I'm thinking this, I'm thinking of all the like different, you know, foot movements and all of that stuff. And I also knew that Ludacris used this for Splash Waterfalls, the same sample. So now I'm thinking, okay, I have to flip it another way. So I'm fighting against three or four different thought processes. The second song that I sampled in Duckworth for Kendrick was called Ostabi Tribe.
Ostabi Tribe.
That's a lot going on. Progressive rock or prog rock has been a thing that a lot of us has been sampling for a while. As Q-Tip started sampling jazz, Dilla and Madlib really started to go to other countries and started digging there. So prog rock became like a thing. If I have a loop or a part of a sample that I want, I piece it together in my mind like a puzzle. I have this part. I have a middle to go along with it. Now I need an end.
He beat the case and went back to hustling. Bird shuffling, Anthony rang. The first in the projects with the two-tone Mustang.
The third song that I sampled is some close friends of mine. Atari by Hiatus Coyote. One of my producers, Cash, came to me and said, man, there's some sounds on this record. We started to go through the record and I ran up on...
Out over the edge you'll find.
I read in an article one time that P. Rock said he did 25 beats a week. That's 1,000 jumpers a day. Am I shooting 1,000 jumpers a day? Or am I shooting 200 jumpers a day? And so I started to come up with a thing called 30 before Thursday. I start on Monday, and my goal is to have 30 beats before Thursday. I will listen to every song on the record. So by the time another producer came along, they say, man, you took every great sample off of this record. There's nothing left. So after a while, you know, I had like 8 Hiatus Coyote beats. So now I'm sampling the now and sampling my friends.
Crooked cops told Anthony he should kick it. He brushed him off and walked back to the Kentucky Fried Chicken. See at this chicken spot there was a light-skinned nigga that talked a lot with a curly top and a gap.
I'm just doing what Pete did for me. Pete and Prem did for me and what James Brown did for them. It's still just a paying it forward. I just always look at it as a link in the chain, man. Like, it's a link in the chain. So it trips me out, but, you know, I still, man, these young boys getting better. This is not like the NBA where you can retire. Like, this is, you have to keep going. That's what makes Duckworth the joint, because of that. Three countries, the sample came from three different countries with three different generations, three different genres, covering all parts of Kendrick's life, involving three people, him, his dad, and Top Dog.
Did y'all ever have that conversation?
Nah, I'm hitting him today and I'm gonna ask him. I'm hitting Kendrick today. Say, hey man, did you know? Did you mean to do this? Because it's exactly, that's what it is. It's threes all the way across.
Man, Ninth Wonder is such a legend, dude. Yes, and yeah, I wanted to conclude the hour with that one because I felt it encapsulated all the samples and edits. And sorry, hold up. Had to put the music back on first. Like, this one is called I1.RMX by 20 Weeks. Yeah. I'll lower it a little bit. But yeah, I chose that one to conclude the hour because it was like a nice little breather, you know, from all like the dance clips and the movies, and just to get something kind of clean. And yeah, the visuals were super dope, and it would have been hella fun to do visuals on that, you know, motion graphics and After Effects and whatnot. But anyways, thanks for joining. I'm your host, your co-host, Belinda. Kaz is about to be on. This is my last track of the hour. And yeah, look into 20 Weeks. It's a pretty good one.